Incest in anime has become increasingly common as the years go by. Surely there were shows that showcased this taboo dating back at least to the 1984 hentai series Cream Lemon, which wasn't completely incestual. There were other types of sexual imagery in it, which, when you think about who's credited for the key animation, you might question your love for a certain anime. Quite honestly, there's a plethora of people out there that have become tired of this kind of theme, especially when it gets shoehorned into more serious shows. Apocalypse at Incest High School? Check. Dot Hack, Legend of the Underage Twincest Warriors? Check. But there's a ton of shows from all throughout the history of anime that have had incest included as a core theme to the series, whether that be because the theme saw popularity, or to try to provide a commentary on the morality of an incestuous relationship. There was Kiss Sis, Oni Ai, Ore no Imouto, and so many more that incest could become someone's go-to subgenre nowadays. To start with, it might be good to get an idea for why there's so much incest in anime in general. There are a lot of different stories floating around as to why incest is so common in anime, and it begs the question that if Japan is a nation that idolizes incest. Let's clear the air with a lot of things. There's a ton of posts on the internet that are unverified accounts linking back to sources that either no longer exist or exist for a different purpose. Some of these accounts talk about how incest used to be common back in feudal Japan, and a father would marry his daughter when the mother passed on, or that Japan's incest law was abolished in 1881. However, just because the law allows children born of incest, it doesn't allow incest marriages. It's important to take account that the sources I found all this information on are Yahoo Answers, My Anime List, and various other message boards. In 1993, Terry McCarthy wrote an article for British newspaper The Independent, in which Satoru Saito, sociopathology department head at the Psychiatric Research Institute of Tokyo, comments that he doesn't believe incest is any more common in Japan than elsewhere. However, there's a sort of emotional incest between mothers and sons. It's no doubt that many people who have bothered to look into anything relating to Japan knows that work consumes the Japanese people. They live to work. Because of this culture, where husbands work long days and go out drinking with their co-workers, mothers who do stay home with their children tend to redirect their affection towards their children. McCarthy goes on to mention that Japanese women tend to complain about the mindset this puts young men into, one that needs their mother for emotional security. In 1997, Takeshi Ito published an article in the Mainichi Shimbun, which was later reshared on the internet by Michael Hoffman. This article unfortunately hosts a broken link back to the Mainichi website, so the contents of this article may be questionable, and also claims that there may be mistranslations in this reprint. Off the start, the article begins by stating that this is far from the general Japanese behavior or sense of worth, seemingly supporting Satoru Saito's claims further. However, it accounts for people that have taken the emotional incest Saito-san speaks of a little too far. Chronicling families that have used incest as a resource to help their children succeed in school and not get distracted by outside factors. The article goes on to chronicle different stories from various different families, ranging from a 28-year-old mother who used sex as a means to improve her 12-year-old son's grades, and a 37-year-old mother who gave favors to her daughter's teacher's 14-year-old son. The numbers here might be baffling you, especially if you come from a different area in the world where the age of consent is just much higher. With a look into how this is playing out in Japan, it's no surprise to see that anime has stories reflecting these pieces of their current culture. While some of these stories do get sexual, so do these relationships in reality, but a decent majority of them that we actually see are more emotionally charged, as Saito-san had stated. This brings me to an anime that I don't really hear talked about much anymore, with the arrival of much better looking shows in the new age, and that's Koi Kaze. I fell in love with the show the minute the incest vibe started, and I know that may sound weird, but it was completely due to the main character's reaction over everything that was going on. He didn't understand his own feelings, he didn't know why he felt the way he did towards his sister, he thought he was wrong, and this got heavily showcased in a scene pretty early in the series where the protagonist, Koshiro, picked up his sister Nanoka's bra, smelled it, and began masturbating to the thought of her. After he's finished, we see his face flushed with guilt, his interactions with her filled with fear, the fear that he believes that she knows what he did. Is what he did morally wrong? Is it okay for Koshiro, the 27-year-old brother, to be masturbating to his 15-year-old sister? If the two previous articles are any indication of how the Japanese handle incest, Koshiro kind of fits exactly what Saito-san described. Koshiro was separated from his mother and Nanoka when Nanoka was extremely young. It was a civil separation between the parents, and the doors were always open for Koshiro to visit his mother. but instead he lived out his life with his father, and we're led to believe that he never actually visited his mother until Nanoka came back into his life over a decade later. When the story begins, we learn that Koshiro is losing the only remaining woman in his life. At least, from a Western perspective, that's what we would assume. The girl he's been seeing breaks up with him because she found someone else. Not long after this, Nanoka comes back into his life. But there is one other woman that was there the whole time, which, as Westerners, we probably wouldn't exactly associate with a woman in my life. Further into Saito-san's thinking, he details something he calls the ofukuro function, or pouch function. While the idea of emotional incest is something that limits a male's interaction outside that of his mother, and further begins to make him crave a motherly figure as a safety net, the ofukuro function describes that this can actually go beyond just a mother figure, and bleed into female bartenders, schools, and places of work themselves. Koshiro has one recurring female character that hangs around him, and that's his supervisor, Kaname Chidori. There's a few scenes where we might get the idea that Kaname is interested in him, but in general, she's his safety net. She's there to make sure Koshiro doesn't make a bad decision, to guide him along his way. Of course, over the course of Koi Kaze, Koshiro and Nanoka's relationship begins to go beyond just this emotional incest, and Kaname is the one person who sees the progression of this and worries about it. A well-known idea in the study of incest is the Westermarck Effect, which states that humans tend to become disinterested in those that they spend their early life with. The separation of these two children at young ages for an extended period of time could support the idea that they never experienced this, as Nanako was just seen as a crying kid to the much older Koshiro, and he never got to actually see her grow up. But what's the morality of all of this? Just because this happens in rare events in Japan and the whole ofukuro function exists, is an event such as Koi Kaze considered taboo? Or, in general, is the entire idea of incest between more similar age individuals as bad as most people perceive it to be? We have to first account for the stations that Koi Kaze aired on, being TV Asahi and Kid Station. Yes, Koi Kaze, a TV anime that includes a masturbation scene and a later implied sex scene between two siblings 12 years apart, aired on a station called Kid Station, a network that primarily airs cartoon material to children and material targeted towards teens during the late night. Think of something like Cartoon Network or Adult Swim. However, Koi Kaze's 8th episode was blocked from airing on TV Asahi. You may be already thinking that it's because of everything I said the show is. No, it's because the episode dealt with divorce and that was considered too taboo to show on television. Makes you think about the taboo of the rest of this show and what Japan thinks about that, huh? The first target of this would most likely be the age of the characters. You're probably questioning, so is it okay for a 27-year-old to have sex with a 15-year-old? If you've ever found yourself wondering, why are all these hot anime girls like 13 years old? Why are they sexualizing the kids? Or, if she's 13, then I'm 13. Look no further. The age of consent in Japan is 13. Or that's probably what you found from a simple Google search and became baffled by it even more. Nationally, yes, the age of consent in Japan is 13, but it still requires parental consent upwards of age 20. Each prefecture in Japan has their own ordinances that may raise the age of consent higher, most commonly around 16 or 18. Koi Kaze's anime takes place over the course of a year, and the manga over the course of 2 years, so really, 28 or 29-year-old Koshiro is having sex with possibly legal 16 or 17-year-old Nanoka, depending on their prefecture law. This still doesn't bring us to the big elephant of the entire conversation that seems like it's been danced around. Even if it's legal for Koshiro and Nanoka to be together, both through age and with the abolition of incest law, is it right for them to be together? When looking at incest, we have to look at it from a broad scope. Most of us are taught that it's wrong, that it's disgusting, and through the aforementioned Westermarck effect, are conditioned to not even think about it in passing. There's a few scenarios I would like to present, some of which are chronicled in extremely well-known texts. In a very rare occurrence, what if your family is the last one left on Earth? Or at least you perceive that as the case, and it's up to you, or at least you think it's up to you, to begin repopulation of the human species. Or maybe it's just threatening the bloodline of your family, and without doing something, the family bloodline will die. All of these possibilities are encompassed in the Bible. In an account more widely regarded as truth, known as history, you know, just in case me bringing up the Bible to discuss incest doesn't suit you very well, Monarchs even married within the family around the world. Korean Goryeo dynasty monarch Gwangjong married his sister Daemok to prevent influence from other families. In the end, Koshiro and Nanoka are but a speck of dust in comparison to any of these people that went down in history. They're just normal people, living their lives, a little different than the norm, but I agree with Saito-san. Incest in Japan doesn't really seem any more common than elsewhere in the world throughout history. The media is a powerful tool that can make you believe whatever it wants you to believe. And it's up to you to decide whether their relationship is morally wrong or if they're okay to live the way they want to, regardless of who it may harm in the process.